President, please be seated. The court is now in session.
L'audience est ouverte.
Today, the chamber hears testimony of a witness through TCW 950.
Aujourd'hui, la chambre entendra le témoin de TCW 950.
In relation to the treatment of the jam.
Ce témoin déposera group. Sur le segment relatif au traitement.
We also have a reserve witness to TCW
904.
The hearing of the testimony of a witness to TCW 950 will take 2 days.
La déposition
One day
de TCW
will be allotted
250
to the co-prosecutors
jours,
and the lead co-lawyers, while the second day is allotted to the defense teams. Ms. Jesse Huang, please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals at today's proceedings.
Quotidien.
Greffier.
La greffier.
Mr. President, for today's proceedings, all parties to discuss are present. Mr. Nunji is present in the holding cell downstairs. He has waived his right to be present in the courtroom.
Il a renoncé à son droit d'être présent.
The waiver has been delivered to the greffier.
Un document à cet effet a été remis à la chambre.
A witness who is to testify today, that is to TCW 950, confirms that to the best of his knowledge, he has no relationship by blood or by law to any of the three accused, that is Nunji and Kyo Sampong, or to any of the civil parties admitted in this case. The witness took an oath before the Ironclad statue this morning,
devant la statue du génie à la
and he has Mr.
Doug Parry
as his duty counsel and Madame Saksita for the afternoon session. He is ready to be called by
Madame,
the chamber.
Plutôt Maître Sorita, cet après-midi.
President, thank you, Mr. Jie Xiuhuang. The chamber now decides on
le
the request
président.
By Nun Jie.
Merci.
The chamber has received a waiver from
La chambre est saisie d'un document présenté par Nunji,
dated 5 October 2015, which states that due to his health, headache, back pain, he cannot sit or concentrate for long, and in order to effectively participate in future hearings, he requests to waive his right to participate in and be present at the 5th
dans le prétoire October 2015
hearing. He affirms that his counsel has advised him about the consequences of this waiver, that it cannot in any account be construed as a waiver of his rights to be tried fairly or to challenge evidence presented to or admitted by this court at any time during this trial. Having seen the medical report of Nunji by the duty doctor for the accused, at the ECCC dated 5 October 2015, which notes that Nunji today has chronic back pain when he sits for long and recommends that the chamber grant him his request so that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information and pursuant to Rule 81.5 of the ECCC internal rules, the chamber grants Nunji his request to follow today's proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs via audiovisual means. The chamber instructs the AV unit personnel to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that Nunji can follow the proceedings. This applies to the whole day. Court officer, please usher the witness as well as his duty counsel into the courtroom.
Dans la salle d'audience.
President, good morning, Mr. Witness.
Bonjour, monsieur le témoin.
What is your name?
Comment vous appelez-vous?
Witness, my name is Ban Seak.
Le témoin, je m'appelle Ban Seak.
Thank you, Mr. Ban Seak.
Merci, monsieur Ban
Seak. And when were you born?
Quand êtes-vous né?
And please observe the microphone.
Puis-je vous prie attendre que votre micro soit allumé?
And I was born in 1954.
Je suis né en 1954.
Questioned, and where
Question.
Were you born?
Où êtes-vous né?
Please wait for the microphone to be operational first before you speak.
Que votre micro soit allumé, s'il vous plaît.
And I was born in the Seikrop village.
Je suis né dans le village de Seikrop.
Monkolborei district.
District de Monkolborei.
Bantimenchei province.
Province de Bantimenchei.
Says the witness.
Dit le témoin.
Questioned. And where do you currently live?
Question. Où habitez-vous?
Answer.
Réponse.
I live in Oenkien village, Anlongveng commune, Odarmenchei province.
La province d'Odarmenchei, district d'Anlongveng.
Questioned. What is your current occupation?
Question. Quelle est votre profession?
Answer.
Réponse.
I am retired, and before
that,
I was a member of the district council.
J'étais membre du conseil du district.
Question. What are the names of your parents?
Comment s'appellent vos parents?
Answer. My father is Hong Hyun and my mother is Long Ping.
Long Ping.
Question. What is your wife's name and how many children do you have?
Combien d'enfants avez-vous?
Answer. My wife is Hong Pon.
Mon épouse s'appelle Hong Pon.
And we have 9 children together.
Et nous avons 9 enfants.
President, thank you, Mr. Ban Seak. The greffier made an oral report that you are not related by law or by blood to any of the accused, that is, Nguyen Kisum Porn, or any of the civil parties admitted in case 002. Is this information correct? Answer, yes, it is. And question. Have you taken an oath
Avez-vous
before the Iron Crab statue?
Devant la statue du génie à la barre de fer?
Answer, yes, Réponse. I have.
Oui.
President, the chamber would like now to inform you of your rights and
la
obligations
vous
as
de vos
a witness in the proceedings before this chamber.
Comme témoin.
And Mr. Ban Seak. As a witness in the proceedings before the chamber, you may refuse to respond to any question or to make any comment which may incriminate you. That is your right against self-incrimination. This means that you may refuse to provide your response or make any comment that could lead you to being prosecuted. Now, on your obligations, and Mr. Ban Seak, as a witness in the proceedings before the chamber, you must respond to any questions by the bench or relevant parties. Except where your response or comment to those questions may incriminate you, as the chamber has just informed you of your rights as a witness.
De vous informer de votre droit à ne pas déposer contre vous-même.
You must tell the truth that you have known, heard, seen, remembered, experienced, or observed directly about an event or occurrence relevant to the questions that the bench or parties pose to you. And Mr. Ban Seak, have you been interviewed by investigators from the office of the co-investigating judges? If so, how many times, when and where?
Où et quand?
Answer.
Réponse.
I was interviewed twice at the district office.
C'était au bureau
and
du district.
Three times at my home and one
Donc,
time
deux fois
at the
district,
ECCC premise.
Chez moi et une fois sur au tribunal.
Questioned. Which district
Question.
Office are you referring to,
À quel
Mr.
bureau
Inez?
De district faites-vous référence, Monsieur Le Témoin?
Answer, I refer to the Anlong Wang district office.
Du bureau de district d'Anlong Wang.
Question.
Question.
And do you recall the dates for each
Vous
interview that you have counted so far? And from my recollection, it's six times that
you
have been interviewed. Answer, I cannot recall them.
Non, je ne me souviens pas des dates.
Question.
Question.
And before you appear before the chamber, have you reviewed or read the written records of your statements with the OCIG investigators in order to refresh your memory?
Afin de vous rafraîchir la mémoire.
And I read it last night, and I also read it this morning.
Oui, je les ai lus la nuit dernière
Question.
Et ce matin.
And to your best knowledge and recollection,
Question.
Do the written records of your interviews reflect the accuracy of your
donné.
Statements you provided to the OCIG investigators? Answer.
Réponse.
Yes. However,
oui.
In certain cases, the questions
Mais dans certains
are
cas,
repetitive.
Ces questions sont répétitives.
President, what
Le
I'd like to ask whether Alors, the written records
si
of your interviews reflect
établi,
the
words
that you
à vos déclarations.
Provided to the OCIG investigators? I mean, are they consistent with what you told the investigators?
Est-ce ce que vous avez dit aux enquêteurs?
Answer, yes.
Réponse.
They are the same.
Oui. Oui, ça correspond.
President and Mr. Ban Siet, you have been provided with a duty counsel based on the request through the
permanence vous accompagne
and
d'après
for
votre
that
demande
we have counsel
que vous avez formulé à la section
d'appui
au témoin aux
session.
Experts. Voilà donc pourquoi Maître Paris
and
est avec
Madame
nous.
Madame Sokita will be your duty counsel for the okay. afternoon
Maître
session.
Maître Paris ce matin et Maître Sokita sera votre avocate cet après-midi.
And pursuant to Rule 91 of the ECCC Internal Rules, the Chamber gives the floor first to the co-prosecutors to put the questions to the witness, and the combined time for the co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyers for civil parties is one day. You may proceed.
Vous avez la parole.
Thank you, Mr. President. Morning, Your Honors, Counsel, Mr. Witness.
Le procureur. Merci, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour.
My name is Dale Lysak. I'll be asking you some questions today on behalf of the co-prosecutor, the international co-prosecutor.
Au nom du co-procureur.
I want to start with a few questions about your background.
J'aimerais commencer par des questions
earlier in this trial, we heard testimony from Su Sun, the wife of a Central Zone Secretary Kai Pok. Were you related to Su Sun? And if so, how were you related to her?
She is my elder-in-law, as she is married to my cousin.
Elle est, c'est ma cousine par alliance.
Well, let me just clarify that. Is your wife, or your deceased wife,
votre
was
épouse,
she a relative of Su Sun?
Était-elle de la même famille que Su Sun? Réponse.
Yes, oui. My wife is related to
Mon
her.
Épouse est de la même famille.
And how are they related?
Et quel est ce lien?
She's the cousin.
Mon épouse est sa cousine.
Or my wife.
Sosun est la cousine de mon épouse.
When did you and Question. Your wife marry?
Quand avez-vous épousé votre femme? Réponse.
I cannot recall that. However, I got married when I was 18 years old.
Je me suis marié à 18 ans.
And you've indicated you were born in March 1954.
Et vous dites être né en mars 54.
Would that mean then you were married sometime around 1972?
Cela veut-il dire que vous êtes marié en 72?
I think it is about 1970, Réponse. But I cannot recall it
je pense
exactly.
Que c'était en 1970, mais je ne m'en souviens pas précisément.
When you were married, did Susan, her husband Kai Pak, or her brother Un, did any of them come to your
Est-ce
wedding?
Est-ce que Kai Pak, Susan ou son frère Un sont-ils venus à votre mariage?
But,
Réponse.
No.
Non.
When did you first get to meet your in-laws, Susan and her brother Hun, and Susan's husband Kai Pak? When was the first time that you met those people?
Quand avez-vous rencontré ces gens la première fois?
But,
Réponse.
I met them when I was at the fishing lot.
C'est quand j'étais sur le terrain de pêche.
Okay, let's turn to that period.
Question.
You've talked about this in your OCIJ interviews. You stated that you worked in the sector 42 fishing lots in Presap district. Kampongcham province from 1975 to early 1977. Do you remember, was Su Sun also based in Presap district in 1975?
But
I did not know about that.
Réponse. Je ne le savais pas.
Where was it that you worked when you were in the fishing
où
unit
in that district? De pêche
were you on the Mekong, on or near the Mekong River?
Étiez-vous proche du fleuve Mekong?
Yes, we fish along the Mekong River.
Réponse, oui, nous pêchions dans le Mekong.
And in late 1975, during the time
that
you were working in the sector fishing unit,
were
you aware of any Cham people who were moved across the river from the east zone to Prek Prasap district?
De la zone est jusque dans le district de Prek Prasap?
No, I was not.
Réponse, non.
I want to see if I can refresh your memory, perhaps, on this, and read to you an excerpt from a document that is in evidence in this case. A document E3/154. This is a telegram from the East Zone, that was sent to Pol Pot and copied to Nguyen Chea on the 30th of November 1975 regarding relocations of the Cham people that were taking place at that time. And the excerpt that I would like to read to you from this telegram states, quote, on 30 November, both sides agreed that the handover of people by the East Zone to the North Zone should take place in Stung Trong and in Pre Prasap. In Pre Prasap, the North Zone would receive those from Shlong District, whereas Stung Trong would receive those from Pim Chi Ling and Krok Chamar districts. And continuing in the next paragraph, the meeting decided that we must not return the Cham to Krachi. The Northwest Zone and the North Zone must receive them in order to separate them from the banks of the Mekong River to ease tensions. End of quote. Mr. Witness, does this refresh your memory at all? Do you remember anything about transfers of Cham people to Prek Prasap and Stung Trong from districts across the river in the East Zone in late 1975 or early 1976?
No, I was not aware of that.
Non, je n'étais pas au courant.
The next subject I'd like to ask you about today is something you talk about extensively in your interviews, which is the purge of the central or old North Zone cadres. In your interviews, you state that in early 1977, at the time of the purge of that zone, you left Prek Prasap district and were appointed first the Sector 42 Deputy Chief of Public Works,
chef
in charge of road repairs, and later the Sector 42 Commerce Chief.
Chef du commerce du secteur 42.
First, who was it that appointed you to those sector
positions?
Eun, who is my cousin-in-law,
qui est mon cousin par alliance,
took him in and, in fact, was appointed to be a deputy of a so-called garage. It's like a branch.
Pour,
and later on, appointed to be chief of the commerce unit for about 3 months.
J'ai été nommé à la tête de l'unité du commerce pendant 3 mois.
You said that Un was your cousin-in-law. Was he the brother of Su Sun?
C'était le frère de Su Sun.
He was the younger brother of
Su Sun.
And what was Un's position at the time he made these appointments?
Un, au moment où il a, où il vous a nommé.
He was
réponse.
The Sector 42 secretary.
C'était le secrétaire du secteur 42.
I want to ask you about how Un became the Secretary of Sector 42. Can you describe for the court what you remember About the period when cadres from the central or old north zone were purged and replaced by other cadres. Can you give us a general description of what you remember about that period?
Description générale de cette période, d'après vos souvenirs?
From 1975, I was a combatant, but I was told that a purge was conducted from the top to the bottom in the east zone.
De haut en bas dans la zone.
And actually, the chief of my fishing unit
le
was taken away
de pêche a été emmené
together with his children
avec
and
ses
wife.
Enfants et son épouse.
Just to clarify something, the English translation I got said east zone. Are you talking about the central or old north zone?
De la zone centrale, anciennement zone nord?
I refer to the north zone or the central zone.
And during this purge, how many of the old North Zone cadres were arrested?
Answer. To my observation, all of them were purged. There were only two people remained, Bok and Uyên, chiefs of party, said the witness. Only two people remained, and the rest were purged.
Les autres ont été éliminés.
What do you remember about how all these cadres were arrested, or how they disappeared? What can you tell us about that?
Ces cadres ont été arrêtés, ou dans la façon dont ces cadres ont disparu.
Answer. They said that these people were linked to CIA
ils
agents.
Ont dit que ces personnes avaient des liens avec la CIA ou avec les agents de la CIA.
When this purge was going on and these cadres were being arrested, did any of them try to resist or fight back?
Est-ce qu'il y a eu une résistance? Est-ce que certains d'entre eux ont essayé de résister?
All of them were called into a study session, after which they disappeared.
And how did things change in your region when, at the time that the old cadres were arrested, and new cadres from the southwest zone arrived? Can you tell us how things changed in your region at that time?
After purges, southwest cadre came in to replace. I did not know what was going on about the reshuffle or about the change in structure.
Did the Southwest cadres mistreat the people in your region?
Maltraitaient-ils les gens dans votre région?
Answer.
Réponse.
At that time, a sense of fear happened
à cette époque-là,
in
y avait
the area.
Un sentiment de
and
peur
if
dans
one
la région.
Could not do the harvest, the short rice transplant,
moissonner,
they were accused of being enemies.
Alors, on les accusait d'être
I heard from other people saying about this matter. I did not witness
it.
What to read to you a statement That was made by Kai Pak, the former zone secretary, in an interview he gave in 2002. This is document E3/2782, also E3/2783. ERN cites English 00089714, Khmer 00095552. And French 00596212. In this interview, Kai Pak accused the cadres who came from the southwest of, quote, severely mistreating the people. He gave an example of a southwest cadre assigned to Sandan district who had burnt people to death in a brick kiln. And he made the following statement, I quote, evil cadres from the southwest zone caused a lot of trouble to my zone, end of quote. Based on what you saw during this period, do you agree with Kai Pak's description of the southwest cadres who came to your zone?
Mr. President, good morning. Good morning, Your Honours. I object to this.
President, please hold on, Mr. Witness. Please wait and listen to the objection of the defense team for Mr. Nunjia. Mr. Copé, please repeat what you have just said. You may now have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. President. I object to this question. The witness just said that he did not witness anything himself in terms of treatment or mistreatment by Southwest Zone cadres. Hence, reading this particular part of Kai Pak's statement would only lead to speculation on the part of this witness. So I object to this question.
If I may respond, Mr. President, I'm following a practice that's been followed by everyone in this court, including defense counsel. I asked an open-ended question. Now I'm reading a piece of evidence in this case to see if that refreshes the memory of the witness, if he has any reaction to this. This is a practice that has been followed by everyone in this courtroom.
Suivi par tout le monde ici.
Chambard Adjol.
President, the objection put by the defense team for Mr. Nunjia is overruled. Co-prosecutors, together with other defense counsel or other parties, please avoids asking the witness to give opinion or to give his or her understanding so that we may avoid any testimony that cannot be admitted by the chamber. So please avoid asking for objective opinions from the witness. So please give your response to the last question put by the International Deputy Co-Prosecutor, if you recall it. Witness, I do not know about the matter because I was a youth in the fishing lots at the time.
Well, I'm actually asking now, Mr. Witness, about the time period after the fishing lots. The period in 1977, when you initially were a deputy chief of the sector of public works, and then Sector 42 chairman, during that period, Mr. Witness, did you observe any mistreatment or conduct by Southwest cadres similar to what Kai Pak talked about?
Qui ressemblerait à ce qui a été décrit par Kai Pak.
Answer, I have no idea about that.
To your knowledge, Mr. Witness, did Kai Pak trust the cadres from the Southwest zone? Did he want the old North Zone cadres to be removed and replaced by cadres from the Southwest?
I do not understand the matter you have just raised.
Let me be a little more specific. And perhaps at this time, Mr. President, with your leave, if I may provide to the witness his prior OCIJ statements. I have five of statements in the interest of time. With your leave, I'd like to provide all of them to him at this time. And for the record, the five statements are E3/5275, E3/375, E319/19.3.73, E319/19.3.86, and E319/28.3.1. With your leave, may I provide these statements to the witness?
Avec votre autorisation, puis-je faire remettre ces PV d'audition au témoin?
President, are you referring to which witnesses' testimonies at this stage?
Des PV d'audition de quel témoin?
These are the OCIJ statements of this witness, Mr. Van Seek.
Mr. President.
President, you may not proceed to Mr. Koppe.
Thank you, Mr. President. I know this has been done before, this practice, so you will probably grant the request, but it still doesn't make any sense to provide the witness with his WRIs. He has already seen them. He just testified to answering questions from you. Asking now to read along with excerpts doesn't contribute really to anything. So, although I know that the practice has been condoned, we object now in respect of this particular witness, reminding you also that we are still waiting for a decision, anxiously waiting for a decision from the Chamber in respect of our request not to give any documents, any WRIs to the witness who is testifying.
If I may, very briefly, Mr. President, this is normal practice in this court, and it's a fair for the witness that if I'm going to ask him about a specific response in his interviews, that he have the responses for him to look at himself.
The Chamber decides to overrule the objection put by the defense team for Mr. Nunchia. Because there have been a practice, existing practice so far regarding the matter. And the chamber informed the party last week already, and the chamber is in the process of examining and deciding the request of Mr. Defense Team, Mr. Nunjie Defense Team, and we will inform parties in due course. Court officer, you are instructed to bring all the documents and provide it to the witness.
Tous les documents au témoin.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Witness and your counsel, the statement I'd like you to refer to right now is the last one in that group, E319/28.3.1, answer number 3 at the very end of that answer. You made the following statement, quote, according to what I knew of the situation during that time, Kaipok did not have a good relationship with San Sen, and he did not trust the Southwest Zone cadres. End of quote. How is it that you knew that Kaipok did not trust the Southwest cadres?
Answer. I do not understand this matter either. Sun Sen was more senior than a Kaipok. He was above a Kaipok, and I do not know about the policy of those people above.
La politique de ces gens au-dessus.
We're talking about the purge of your zone. Do you know who was responsible for ordering the arrests of the central or north zone cadres? Was that something that Kaipok decided to do himself?
As a youth during that time, it was not Kaipok. The order was not from Kaipok. It was from the higher level, the focal points, and the cadres disappeared. Perhaps it was from the higher echelon. And some of them perhaps were sent to Phnom Penh, not to other zones.
À Phnom Penh et pas dans d'autres zones.
Let me read a short excerpt of something you said along those lines in your interview E319/19.3.86 at answer number 64. You said, quote, to my knowledge, decisions or orders to purge or kill were made by Office 870. That was not for Kaipok or the sectors to decide. End of quote. My question is, how did you know this? How did you know that orders to purge or kill came from Office 870?
At that time, cadres belonged to Kaipok. After we learned that Kaipok disappeared, we lost hope. So the order, I believe, did not come from Kaipok. It was from a higher echelon. And cadres from other zones disappeared besides only the Southwest Zone cadre remained.
La zone sud-ouest sont demeurés.
You've stated that it was in early 1977 that Un became Sector 42 secretary, and you were assigned initially to your position in the Public Works sector unit. Do you remember what month in 1977 this took place?
Ce changement a eu lieu.
Answer, I cannot recall it, Mr. Co-Prosecutor.
Mr. President, at this time, try to refresh the memory of the witness and to establish some of the cadres who disappeared at this time, I'd like to provide to the witness E3/2956, E3/2956. This document is an S21 list titled List of Persons from the North Zone, February 1st, 1977 to 27 March 1977. Which identifies in total 94 cadres from the North Zone who were arrested and sent to S21 during that period. With your leave, may I provide that to the witness so that I may ask him about some of the individuals named on that list?
Mr. President?
Yeah.
I object on the same basis as I have always objected to this practice. He has no connection whatsoever to the particular S21 document. He hasn't been working in S21. He wasn't involved in the arrests of these people, knowing, of course, that you will overrule the objection, but for the benefit of a possible second appeal, I object to this practice.
I'll be brief, Mr. President. This is something that's been ruled on before. The witness is a sector-level cadre who will know some of the people on this list, and that is the foundation basis for asking him questions about the list.
By the defense counsel for Mr. Nguyen-Chia, Mr. Coppe,
de Maître Coppe de la Défense
is overruled in relation to the document requested to present to the witness. Because I have been told already there has been existing practice and there is no change in circumstances and also there is no decision altered the previous practice. Court officer, please accept and please take the document and present it to the witness.
Huissier d'audience, veuillez faire remettre le document au témoin.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, the document you've received, E3/2956, identifies various cadres from your zone who were arrested and sent to S21 in February or March 1977. I want to refer you first to number 42 on the list. If you look for number 42, I've highlighted that entry. That person is Chan Mon Mol, alias Toll, who is identified as the chairman of Sector 42 and who entered S21 on the 19th of February 1977. My question, Mr. Witness, do you remember Toll? Was he the Sector 42 secretary before UN?
Le secrétaire de la région 42 avant UN.
Answer. His name was Toll.
Son nom c'était Toll.
He was working and living in Batna.
Il travaillait et habitait à Batna.
He became the secretary prior to Uyen's tenure.
Avant Uyen.
I do not recall the full name, but from my recollection, it was Tol, not Tol.
Mais son nom n'était pas Tol, mais Tol.
Excuse my pronunciation, Mr. Witness. This document establishes that in February and March 1977, a Sector 42 Secretary Tol and many other zone, sector, and district cadres were purged. My question to you, was it during this same period, that is February to March 1977, that Un became the new Sector 42 secretary and you were appointed to your position in public works?
Aux travaux publics.
But Mao Nang Eun Mao Chuoi Mao Thơ
Phai Chi was before me, long before me. He was 4 or 5 months before me. Before the time, I was a youth at the fishing lodge.
Auparavant, j'étais un jeune dans le groupe.
Taken to the place by Eun, and I was put to be in charge of the garage or public work. Regarding purges of
cadres,
I have no idea about that because I only noticed that cadres kept disappearing.
So to clarify, is it your testimony that it was a few months after Un became Sector 42 secretary that you were appointed to the public works unit? Do I understand correctly?
Vous avez été nommé aux travaux publics quelques mois seulement après quelques mois que Un a pris ses fonctions comme secrétaire de la région 42.
Answer.
Réponse.
I did not when he came to take the position before he was chief
avant
of Phnom Throl.
Cela,
Phnom Trong, rather.
Il était
he
chef
was
Phnom
from Siem Reap.
Il venait de
and
Siem
later
Reap.
On I heard he
suite,
was promoted to be the
promu,
secretary of the sector. 6 or 7 months later, he was looking for other subordinates to work with him because some cadre had disappeared, focal points had disappeared, the cadres had disappeared.
Let me ask you about the time that you were assigned to be deputy chief of the public works and to work on road repairs. Where was the public works office located? Where were you based during this time period?
Answer. It was located at the intersection, the car garage.
Cela se trouvait à
and
l'intersection.
It was the sector's office over there, and opposite it, it was the garage, the car garage.
Bureau,
I was so scary when
voiture.
I was sent to
et
be in charge of that public works unit because I had a biography.
Which district are you talking about when you refer to an intersection where the sector office was located?
Answer. It was in Jamgale
district,
Svaytip commune.
And how long did you work in the public works unit before you were promoted to Sector 42 Commerce Chief?
Chef du commerce de la région 42.
But
answer, I was in the position for a period of 3 or 4 months, after which I was promoted to be commerce chief.
During the period you were the sector, the sector 42 deputy chief for public works, do you remember who the zone public works chairman was?
Qui était le président?
Eun was the sector's chief.
Chef de secteur. Réponse. C'était Eun.
Yes, I'm asking you about who the zone public works chairman was.
Qui était le président des travaux publics de la zone?
Do you remember who the zone public works chairman was during the period you were in the sector public works unit?
Alors que vous étiez à l'unité des travaux publics du secteur.
Answer. To my knowledge, it was brother Cham.
C'était le frère Cham, je pense.
He is deceased. Previously, he was a messenger of Kai Po.
Il était messager de Kai Po.
Some cadre died. He became to be involved in the public works.
Il a commencé à travailler
usually, the public work was responsible for mixing the cement for building the dam.
De mélanger le ciment pour la construction de barrages.
Do you remember a cadre named Sao, who was the public works chairman before Cham?
Président des travaux publics du secteur.
I don't.
Avant ça, Cham. Réponse, non.
Let's talk about the period now when you became the Sector 42 Commerce Chief.
Que l'on parle du moment où vous êtes
Where was the Sector Commerce Office located?
Où était situé le bureau de commerce du secteur?
No.
It was in a pagoda.
C'était dans une pagode.
I think it's called Cheyu, and
pense
it's
que
in
ça
Spu.
S'appelle Cheyu, elle est à Spu.
As I said, I cannot recall the name of the pagoda.
Je ne me souviens pas du nom de la pagode.
But it was located in that pagoda.
Mais c'était dans cette pagode.
Just so I'm clear, so the Sector 42 Commerce Office
Donc,
where you worked was located in Spu Village in Chaiyu
commune de Chaiyu.
Is that correct?
Est-ce bien le cas? Réponse.
It was in Spu commune. Previously, it was called Chaiyu commune.
Avant, il s'appelait la
commune
de
Chaiyu. However, I'm not exactly clear about the name of the commune, but it was located in Spu,
mais
in a pagoda
à
there.
Dans une pagode.
And how far was the Sector 42 office from the sector office where Eun
bureau du commerce
worked.
Du secteur du bureau du secteur où travaillait Eun?
Un office worked right at the sector office, and he also resided
était
there.
Dans le bureau de secteur, et c'est là qu'il habitait.
What I'm asking you is the sector office where Un worked.
Ce bureau de secteur
was that in the same location as the sector commerce office, or was that it at a different village
le
or commune?
Le bureau de commerce plutôt du secteur, ou était-ce dans une autre commune, dans un autre village? Réponse.
The sector office and the commerce office was far from one another.
Était loin
it
du
was
bureau
about,
du commerce.
2 kilometers away.
2 kilomètres environ.
And they were located in a different commune.
C'était
one
dans
was
une autre
in Svaytip, while the other
Il
was in
Svaytip, alors que l'autre était à Cheyu.
Do you remember who the zone commerce chairman was during the time that you were the sector 42 commerce chief?
Vous étiez chef du commerce du secteur. Qui était le chef du commerce?
His name was Jay.
Réponse, c'était Jay.
And do you remember what happened to Che in 1977?
Souvenez-vous ce qui est arrivé à Che en 1977?
Che réponse. Was arrested.
Che a été arrêté.
And taken to Phnom Penh.
Et il était emmené à Phnom Penh.
Che was actually the younger-in-law of Eun.
Était plus jeune que Eun et de sa belle famille.
Mr. President, at this time I'd like to provide to the witness another S21 list. This is document E3/2957. E3/2957. And also E3/2166. Both of these documents are S21 lists of prisoners from the Central Zone that include some individuals, including a person that I'd like him to identify.
President, yes, yes, you may do so.
Oui, allez-y.
Mr. Witness, if you could look at document E3/2166, first, E3/2166, number 7 on that list of Central Zone cadres is a Zone Commerce Chairman, Peng Sun, alias Chai, who was arrested on the 3rd of October, 1977. Is this the person that you just identified as the zone commerce chief?
Chef de commerce de la zone? Réponse.
I do not know his surname.
Je ne connais pas son nom.
However, Che was the younger-in-law of Kai Po, and was in charge of the zone commerce office. Later on, he was arrested and taken to Phnom Penh. And he was also a younger-in-law of Eun.
Il était aussi de la belle famille de Eun.
And to help us with the time period here, how long had you been Sector 42 Commerce Chief when Chai was arrested?
Depuis combien de temps étiez-vous chef de commerce du secteur quand Chai a été arrêté? Réponse.
I was in the commerce office for a month, and then I heard that Jay was accused of being in the CIA agent network
and was arrested and sent to Phnom Penh.
And do you remember how long you continued to be the Sector 42 Commerce Chief after Chai's arrest?
Chef du commerce du secteur après l'arrestation de Chai? Réponse.
I worked there for about 3 months.
3 mois environ.
And then Eun reassigned me to be the deputy chief of a district in Chamkarlu.
While we're talking about the period you had your positions in a sector, Public Works, and then Sector Commerce, did you know about a dam that was being built in Barai and Santuk districts called the First January Dam?
Était un barrage appelé le barrage du 1er janvier. Réponse.
I knew about that, but I didn't go and work there.
Mais je n'y ai jamais travaillé.
And I knew it because it was built along road
le sais,
number 21.
On construisait ce barrage le long de la route 21.
I understand you didn't work at that site.
Oui,
did you ever go to visit the first January dam work site?
Visite au chantier?
But
réponse.
No.
No.
Did you know a pagoda in Barai district that was close to the first January dam called Wat Barai Chandek?
Portait le nom de Wat Barai Chandek.
I knew that pagoda when I was young.
Je connaissais cette pagode quand j'étais jeune.
And do you know what that pagoda was used for during the Democratic Kampuchea regime?
La période de, du Kampuchea démocratique?
But
réponse.
No, I did not.
In your OCIJ interviews, Mr. Witness, and I'm going to read to you now an excerpt from E3/375, ERN's English 00360761, Khmer 00348802, French 00369924. You gave the following testimony, quote, question, did you know about the security center in Barai Chandek Pagoda? Answer, if you want to get precise, you can ask Bang Pok, who was in charge of Barai district. At least once a month, he visited there. If he could not go, he would assign his subordinates to visit on his behalf. By the way, he cannot respond that he did not know about that. In a district, there were at least four or five members, one of whom was female. When an arrest was made, the district must have known about it. End of quote. You added in a subsequent interview, E319/19.3.86, answer 34, quote, as district secretary, he had to have known about the security office in his district, end of quote. Can you tell us how you knew this information about Hawk's responsibility for the Wat Barai Chandek security office? How did you know this?
But
réponse.
Poach came from the southwest.
Poach venait du sud-ouest.
That is after the cadres of the central zone had gone.
C'est-à-dire, il
so
est venu après
he must have known about the arrest of those cadres.
La zone centrale, la zone nord. Donc, il devait être au courant de l'arrestation de ces
cadres. Or at
least had
knowledge about it or knew the location
savoir
of it.
During what years was Poach the secretary of Barai
district? Poach a été le secrétaire du district de Barai pendant quelle année? Pendant quelle période? Le président.
Witness, please hold on, and Councillor Copper, you have the floor.
Monsieur, monsieur le témoin,
thank you, Mr. President.
In itself, I
don't have an objection to this particular question.
However,
I do like to note that we are in the middle of a segment on the treatment of the Cham.
Ici du traitement des Cham.
And I'm not quite sure if this particular pagoda is relevant what the closing order describes. In terms of treatment of the
Cham,
most of the questions, I think, or if not all the questions, were directed at trying to establish how the structure was in Sector 42. Very interesting, but nothing to do with the treatment of the Cham as such.
Ça n'a pas grand-chose à voir avec le traitement réservé au Cham.
And Mr. President, as with all witnesses, we're allowed to question on all the relevant subjects of the closing order, because we're not going to call these witnesses back. I have questions for this witness, which I've been covering, relating to the purge of the central zone. We'll be getting to questions about the treatment of the CHAM in that zone, but also what Barre Chandek is specifically referenced in the allegations on the first January dam. The individual I'm talking about is a proposed trial witness, so these questions are relevant to this trial.
Donc des questions pertinentes pour le procès.
Bah. Le président. President, you can move on the co-prosecutor, since it is just an observation made by the defense team.
Mr. Witness, please respond to the last question put to you by the co-prosecutor.
Witness, I forget the question.
Le témoin, j'ai oublié la question.
President and the deputy co-prosecutor, please repeat your last question.
Veuillez répéter la dernière question.
Yes, my question was, do you remember what years it was, or what period it was, that Bang Poch was the secretary of Barre District?
Était secrétaire du district de Barre.
I do not recall when it was. Since at that time I was at the fish unit.
À l'époque, j'étais à l'unité
and actually,
de pêche.
At the time, they did not use his name as Poch. They referred to brother A,
Poch,
B or C.
Le frère A, B ou C.
President, thank you, deputy co-prosecutor. It is time for us to have a short break. We have a break now and resume at 10:30. Court officer, please assist the witness during the break time. And invite him as well as his duty counsel back into the courtroom at 10:30. The court is now in recess.
Suspension d'audience.
Veuillez
vous lever.